Andrea knew that the site they had bought was a very odd shape in a very strange situation. It wasn't a typical lot on a street where you could take a house that you liked from somewhere else and then just transplant it on the site. They realized the site has a narrow opening at one end, and it's very long, and it slowly widens to the very far end. And so on the one side, it had a set of disused garages and disused factory buildings, which we knew at some point would be developed. On its other side, it backed onto the gardens of six very small, very beautiful Victorian terraced houses. So that we had a situation which was so atypical that it needed to have a very unique response. Basically, instead of having a front yard, a house, and a backyard, the strategy was to elongate the house and turn it sideways to back it up against the sort of disused factory buildings. So by backing it up against those disused factory buildings and then opening the garden entirely to the length of the south wall, the house is very much a one-sided house, but when you move through the house, you're quite unconscious of that. You actually lose all sense of the fact that the one side is entirely blocked and the other side is completely open. We understood that the housing, which was Victorian and on a very small scale, required something quite gentle next to it. And our response to that was to sink the house down by a meter and a half. So that when you arrive, you descend down, so that the courtyard of the house and the main living spaces of the house, when you're in the courtyard and those rooms, you have no view of the Victorian houses, and they have no view of you. So that the privacy of the neighbors was a very important sort of adjustment to make in the way we designed the house. We knew it was a very long house that crossed the backyards of six Victorian terraces, so our response to that, which we brought to the planners, it wasn't an insistence on their part, was to create this undulating roof form, which is a kind of abstraction of a terrace roof form, rather than a sort of block. And also that the buildings to the front, the elements of the house to the front, sit in the garden like pavilions. So there's a very complex roof form to make the house, to break the house down and to give it a kind of sculptured form. We also decided from the beginning to work with a London stock brick, as all the terraces are. And these are not decisions which are forced on us by planners, but rather things which we do because we want our buildings to be gentle in their surroundings. We're not looking to strike out against our surroundings. We're looking to be integral to them, but at the same time to make very strong contemporary forms. When a house works well, when the journey that you take with the client is one of real communication, it's not that difficult to merge all the ambitions of a client with creating a consistent piece of architecture. The site being kind of quite extraordinary also led to a house which is very unique. Almost unique by necessity, if rather than being unique to be willful. And I think the role that Henry and Andrea played in terms of how they wanted to live, the kind of easy lifestyle that connected the interior to the exterior, the sort of level of comfort without it being ostentatious in any way, just about a comfortable way of living your life, is really embodied in the house that they now have.